Hey everybody, ShadowBlazer3000 here with my next first impression of another winter anime series. I thought this would actually be on time for a change, considering all my others have been like a day or two late, because this one's actually on Crunchyroll where all the others are all off in the friggin' ether somewhere. But unfortunately, I'm still late, because I thought the show was going to go live on Thursday, but it's actually what goes live Wednesday, so there you go. I'm a day late on this one, but I'm here to talk about Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid, the comedy show from Kyoto Animation, whom you either love or you love to hate them, right? KyoAni is, they're the studio that I think everybody knows. They have a claim with shows like The Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya, or more recently Sound Euphonium, which is great. Or Full Metal Panic, Famufu is another one that's very popular. Of course, they produce their share of duds, I guess. I know people are pretty mixed about Beyond the Boundary. I haven't seen it myself, but it looks interesting. I kind of want to see it. Withhold your opinion. If you've seen it, withhold your opinions, because I think I'll probably check that one out. But of course, last year they also produced, at this time, The World of Phantoms, whatever the hell it's called. You know, the one where they are like ghost hunters or some shit, and the girl bounces her boobs to win at Limbo. That was so stupid and so terrible. So here they go, yet another attempt at comedy. I mean, it's not like it's their first comedy ever, you know. They also did Nichijo, which I know was critically praised, but I've always heard that did absolutely abysmal in sales. But anyway, that's not important right now. I'm here to talk about the show Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid. The premise is as crazy as it sounds. The premise actually reminds me a little of Pita 10. If you saw the anime review I did, or if you saw the anime or you read the manga, then you kind of know what you're probably getting into a bit. But the ultimate story here is there's an office lady, an overworked office lady named Kobayashi. That's all we know her as. We don't know her first name or anything. Well, one day she's getting up for work, she opens her door, and outside her door is this large friggin' dragon. Looks like it's about ready to eat her alive, and of course the dragon transforms into a cute little girl, already clad in a maid outfit, because anime, why not? And the girl name is Toru, and she's proclaiming, "I'm here to become your maid now." Apparently, after they met the night before while Kobayashi was out drinking, and so she's a heavy drinker, so she got incredibly drunk and for whatever reason decided to say, "Hey, dragon, want to come stay at my house for a while?" I don't know, but okay. So of course Kobayashi at first doesn't really want to, because there's not much space to... She lives in a little apartment by herself, and there's not much space for her to have this other dragon maid girl come live with her, but she reluctantly agrees because, well, she's late for work and Toru whisks her away up through the sky to get her to her job on time. And the rest of the episode is just kind of situational hijinks, and it's just Toru trying to, you know, how to fit in with our silly human ways, as is so common when you have, like, fantasy creatures that show up. Thankfully, where a lot of other shows might do this, it's not like an excuse for her to run around naked or something. You know, she's already dressed in a maid dress, in fact, because I guess she stopped at a maid cafe. And so she's not like... It's not just an excuse for her to be nude for stupid reasons or for her to be brash. In fact, Toru seems to be overly devoted to Kobayashi. She keeps mentioning that Kobayashi saved her from something. We don't really know what. Maybe we'll learn that a little later. But she mentions that Kobayashi saved me, now I'm going to save her. So she wants to be a loyal, devoted servant to Kobayashi, and she even says she's in love with her. So there you go. We don't need to have 12 episodes of Yuri subtext. It's right there. Except I don't think the feeling's quite mutual. And there's a lot of other, like I said, the episode's very, like, situational little moments, right? Kobayashi goes out drinking with a co-worker, and Toru comes along because Toru comes along. And Toru is insanely jealous of this male co-worker because she wants Kobayashi all to herself. And then there's other moments like, oh, Toru's home alone. Home alone! And she has to protect the apartment from a couple of burglars trying to break in. No, she doesn't set up elaborate booby traps. She just scares them away by being a big old dragon. You know, she learns how to do the laundry. She learns how to cook. She cooks her own tail, in fact. It's pretty funny. I gotta give it that. There's not much of, like, a story, so to speak. I'm sure there's gonna be a story that's gonna kind of develop, but it's very situational hijinks moments here throughout the first episode. And it is pretty entertaining, it is pretty amusing. There's not a lot of HE, there's not a lot of fan service. There is a moment, when they're out drinking and Kobayashi gets really drunk and starts ranting and screaming about random stuff, about being a proper maid and stuff, and, like, demands Toru strip, and she actually rips her clothes off. And, I mean, you only see Toru naked from the back, basically. And there are a little, you know, breast jiggle, I guess. There's a little Gainax scene in it. It's not overt and it's not gratuitous, I guess. There are some really iffy off-color jokes that are probably gonna make you squeam a little. I guess I'll tell you now, there's a moment where, you know, Toru's looking over her Kobayashi's clean clothes, and it's like, she's mentioning, oh, how silly humans have their waste onto their clothes. Such primitive creatures. And then she's like, starts licking the clothes, because it's like, it's Miss Kobayashi's waist. Oh, God. That's probably the one thing that keeps this from being a really great series, is a little bit of cringe and little squeamishness like that. It's like, oh, it's not terrible. Thankfully, it's very brief. And there's another really funny scene where she starts sniffing Kobayashi's laundry, fresh laundry, and it's like, oh, the aroma of Kobayashi, because like I said, says she's already in love with her, so why not? And Kobayashi's like, duh! So, it's a pretty funny episode, I gotta give it that. Even with some of the more squeamish moments, it is a pretty funny show. I think it's only probably gonna get better from here. I mean, there's a lot of other great little moments and pieces, too, that just make up the whole episode that I can't sum up all. You know, she keeps calling up these other dragons, I guess, and asking for advice, and you know, seeing Kobayashi get drunk off her ass, basically, and you know, at the end of the episode, they share a bed together. It's so cute. And it'll be interesting to see where the show goes. I mean, it looks like there is semblance of a underlying story building, and of course, it's based on a manga, and if you read the manga, no spoilers, please. I'd rather just watch the anime. Alright, guys, so pretty short, pretty sweet. Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid is pretty fun and pretty amusing and entertaining. I'll probably definitely keep watching it. It's not as ridiculous and stupid as World of Phantom was, because, well, Toru didn't use her boobs to win at Limbo. That's already a plus in my book. Sorry, guys. So that will do it for this particular one. Now, what should I think be my final vlog will come out tomorrow, and that will be on Scum's Wish.